Hello, my name is Camille. I'm CEO and founder of Riverdi, and today we'll be discussing and showing you actually how different brightness on the displays looks like. If you remember, we had another video which was outdoor LCD displays, where I have explained how brightness and reflections goes into the contrast which we actually see as humans as a result of a brightness and reflections of a display and different surfaces. So we explained there that making the display with the higher brightness, of course, and decreasing reflections is a way to achieve a higher contrast, which is typically like 1 to 10 will be perfect contrast, and higher contrast will be actually excellent, that are even not necessary to have the display readable. But our display line is based on the IPS glass and 1000 candela, which we found out through our experiments that is quite universal to be used indoor and outdoor as well. And today we will show you three different brightnesses. So we'll show you the low brightness display, that is the first display here, which we set to 300 candela. Then we have a 500 candela brightness display, and our standard IPS display, which is 1000 candela display. All of them are 100% the same, so they are all the same TFT glass, the same touchscreen on top, which is our UX Touch industrial touchscreen. So they are built in the same way, so all the reflections are the same. The only difference between these three displays is the brightness that we have set actually by the software using the PMW signal. That is pretty easy with our displays, and we actually measured that, yes, to be sure that we have 300, 500 and 1000 candela displays. I will show you how it looks with different images, so we will see also that the content on the screen matters here as well, and also the light that is going into the display, outside light that we have, the reflections is very important. So we are outdoor on the Riverdi headquarter balcony to have more light. We have a cloudy day today, as you can see behind me. We do it on purpose on this cloudy day to have a little bit less light than on a sunny day. We will have later also we will also record later with the sunny day, so next part of this video will be the, let's say, sunny day reflections. That will be a little bit different story, so we will have it there. So let's have a closer look on the displays that I have on my table. What you see right now, you see all of them are reflecting the clouds, the sky actually, so we don't see much content. Actually, as a human, when I'm standing next to the display, I can read them a little bit. Of course, the 1000 candela display that is on the right side is the most readable for me right now, but actually on all of them I can see a little bit of content. So the first thing when we build our device and we don't have a higher brightness and we want to go outdoor would be to use some kind of shadow a little bit. So that means we should never reflect a display directly with the sky, but actually it's not the case. Yes, normally the display that we use outdoor is in a vertical mode, so what we have as a reflections is not the direct sky as we have it here, but I did it intentionally so we can see how does it look with the sky. And now I will move the camera a little bit and you can see we are going into the shadow with the display, and now you should be able to see differences in a display, and now we see the content. So what we have here is a 300, 500 and 1000 candela brightness, and as you can see, the 1000 candela, the Riverdi standard brightness, is actually the best readable, and I would say perfectly readable in this conditions. So this could be easily used outdoor, and of course indoor as well, because you can, as I already said, decrease the brightness is necessary, but in most cases even 1000 candela is a good indoor brightness, then the display is perfectly readable even in a high light conditions. Maybe during the night it's sometimes worth to decrease the brightness, but in most cases it's not necessary. So the content here, as you see, is a bright content. Yes, so we have the white background, which is pretty important, and then the contrast are quite high, that we achieved here. Now I will go into the dark content, so I change it right now, and now you see the dark content, which is not that readable. The first, let's say, hint would be, if we go outdoor, we should use the white background and high contrast images, so they will be better readable. But still, in these three examples, we see clear differences between 300, 500 and 1000 candela displays in the shadow. And I will go outside the shadow right now, and you see again only actually reflections on the display, which is pretty normal for this kind of display. Okay, so that's it with this part. We will go a little bit deeper with another part, so we will compare the best display from this three, that is a 1000 candela display, with something that is a standard in Riverdi, which is optically bonded display. We will see how does it influence, because all three displays here, they are air bonded. That's why we see this high reflections like right now. So we see the air in between the cover glass and the TFT display. They are creating, this air gap is creating quite a lot of reflections. It will be lower with the optical bonding, but let's see actually how it will look like in the next part of this video. Okay, so we have changed a little bit displays on the table, and right now we have a 500 candela air bonded display here, then 1000 candela air bonded display here, and a 1000 candela optically bonded here. And you can see immediately there is no content on the display yet and no backlight, but you can see that the display with the optical bonding is black on the background. That means we have removed the air gap in between the cover glass and the TFT, so we have no reflections, or almost no reflections, because they are always there a little bit, but they are way lower. That means we will increase the contrast of this display. Actually, it looks beautiful even if the device is switched off. We have a black surface, which we are used to actually from the tablets or mobile phone. They are all optically bonded nowadays. And please remember that Riverdi has no MOQ for optically bonded displays. We were the first company worldwide to introduce into our standard offer. That means you don't need to buy any quantity. You can buy one piece from our website or through our distribution network with this beautiful optically bonded display, any size actually, from 3.5 inch to up to 10.1 inch that we have here on the table, and use this technology into your projects despite the quantity that you have. Yes, it could be 1000, but it could be 100 per year, or even one piece per year. That's fine with Riverdi standard displays that are let's say easily available. Okay, so we see the reflections now directly cloudy day reflections, and let's go into the shadow with this camera. So once I go into the shadow, you see there is almost no difference between the air bonded and optically bonded display. The reflections here, if we are in the shadow, are, let's say, matter a little bit less, but still the optically bonded display will have a better contrast and, let's say, higher viewing angles. All the optical parameters are actually better, because we always have the reflections. Even if we are indoor, we'll have some lamps, etc., they will be reflected with the glass where we have the air bonded case. Okay, so now we will switch on the displays and we will see the content like before. Okay, so now we have the same content as before, so the white background content, some image, like a testing image. So now we see again 500, 1000 candela and 1000 candela again, but optically bonded. And you can see now from this perspective, when we have this cloudy day and actually full reflections of the sky, that is not even the case in normal, in most of the situation, we see a huge difference between optically bonded display and air bonded display. Yes, as you remember, this display in a previous, let's say, set of the displays was the best one, was 1000 candela, but it's air bonded. And here we have the comparison with the optically bonded one, which is way more readable, because now we understand that it has lower reflections. Yes, so the contrast is actually higher. And if I will go to the shadow, We'll see this difference as well. So the optically bonded display is a little bit brighter, and as I mentioned, the viewing angles for sure are better. So even if we're in the shadow or indoor, still optically bonded display will be better readable, better seen. And actually this makes, as we have discussed in another video about the high brightness displays, this will have impact, and huge impact actually, on the overall experience of the user of the device. Yes, so if we'll pay attention and we'll make the display that is not only beautiful but is also like perfectly readable, or the best possible readable, like the Riverdi IPS 1000 candela displays with optical bonding that I strongly recommend for all the projects, then the user experience will be the highest possible. Yes, and then the overall, let's say, opinion about the device will matter and will be judged by a display, as is often the case, because the display is a user interface. Yes, so we use a machine or a device, whatever it will be, a ticket machine or vending machine that will be outdoor or anything else, our experience will be mainly based on a display. So how the touchscreen works and how the display was readable. Okay, so we have the white background content here, and let's switch again to the dark one. So now I switched to the dark one, and we see again let's say advantage of optically bonded. So even with the dark background, that is a let's say the worst for the outdoor or like bright environment application, we see that when we have the optically bonded display, the content actually can be readable even with the direct, let's say, cloudy day reflections. And now I will go back to the shadow mode, and in this mode maybe we don't see the much difference, but as I mentioned, still it's recommended because there will be some other lights in normal cases, like the lamps, and if we want to read the display from the angle, the optically bonded one will be better and better. So when we are straight, maybe the difference is not that high, but actually when I'm standing here a little bit behind the camera and I'm on the different angle than the camera, I see a way better image on the optically bonded display than the air bonded. And the least and the worst one here is of course the low brightness, or like a mid average brightness 500 candela display. So my recommendation of course is to use our display from IPS line, which is 1000 candela, beautiful and high brightness display that will be let's say perfect for most or all applications, either outdoor and indoor of course. Okay, so today you have seen how the three different brightness of a displays, and actually optically bonded display, that is a fourth model presented today, influence the overall contrast that the user see in a cloudy day. And the cloudy day is a very good day for this kind of testing because we have very even light distribution. Yes, so we don't have the spotlight that we will see in the next part of this video when we will have the sunny day, and the reflections will be a little bit different, and probably we'll need to play with the camera to spot the sunlight reflected into the particular display. But today we have perfectly seen how increasing the brightness increase the readability of a display when we are outdoor, but actually indoor works the same when we have a lot of lights. And nowadays we have a lot of lights in our offices or public spaces as well, so everything is quite bright indoor, so we need the high brightness display. And my recommendation of course is to use 1000 candela display as a minimum, either indoor and outdoor. And we have also seen how the optically bonded display increased this readability, so even further increase the readability and the contrast, because it creates lower reflections. That you can learn more about in another video. You can find the link down below to this video where we explain exactly how reflections work and the brightness more in theory, and here we have the practice part. So thank you for now, and let's see another part of this video with the sunny day reflections.